Alright, we got a 1500 point battle today between Saim Hann, Eldar, over here, and awesomely painted Imperial Guard, a full Imperial Guard army. It's 1500 points today. My army, you've seen it before, got three units of jet bikes, one of which is reserving, Seer Council with a Farseer in there, three Vipers of Star Cannons, and two Prisms, because I just painted my second Prism, so I'm going to be testing them out. And over here we got a whole series of Chimeras, looks like a Manticore in there. Yeah, some squads. I think there's a Vendetta outflanking. There's a cool flak tank. I don't even know what that is back
there.
Hydra. Oh, it's pretty sweet there. So it's going to be a hell of a fight. So back in a bit. Running up the top of turn one. Squad of guys jetted over here. Flat out squad over here from over there. These guys just moved up and then hopped 6 inches. Eldar move. Fortune succeeded over there. Some piddly shooting over here. Killed a couple of these guys. They went to ground, but they can obviously do their cool power where they stand up. This guy fired with the help of him to try to hurt a Chimera, but even with the twin length, he missed, and it was a big flub. So that was not a very good turn, but we are on to the Imperial Guard turn. Alright, rounding up the bottom of turn one for the Imperial Guard, an equally crappy turn, just like the Eldar had for their first one. What happened? A lot of shooting came at the council. All saves were made, though. They were just thugs this round. I've never seen that for... It's been a while since I've seen that. They went flat out, so they actually had a cover save against a really nasty gun there, but one guy died. These guys didn't get shot at. Over here, weapon blown off, shaken, he's free to shoot. Shaken over here, so he's not doing any shooting. And that was the round. Let's see if these guys show up on a 4+. No, they are fail. All right, so on to turn two. All right, so finishing the top of turn two, surprisingly good turn. These guys flew over here, side-armored. This guy exploded, and by some unholy miracle, 8 of the guys inside died. Meanwhile, this guy shot a single template here, and by some unholy miracle, blew up his gun. Otherwise, some pointless shooting into the squad here. We did assault, double assault his vehicles. That one survived. He just lost his weapon. This one is wrecked over there. Other than that, that was it. So pretty big turn for the Eldar. That was surprisingly good turn. All right, back in a bit. All right, so rounding out the bottom of turn two, Marbo showed up, threw just some crazy missile, didn't scatter, nuked 5 of the 6 jetpacks that were here, and these melted guys took out the last one, so that was a kill point there. Weapon got blown off from some heavy, I think, Elias cannon over here. Oh, no, sorry, from the Vendetta. The Vendetta came on the board. Look at this awesome flyer guy. And he just nuked a bunch of Elias cannon shots into the rear. Holofield's held, but the weapon's gone, so he's basically just a flying, tank shocker. And some shooting at the council, ineffectual though. Nothing got shot over here. This guy moved forward, tried to flame, but couldn't do much because his big gun is gone. So we are off to another turn. Back in a bit. All right, so squad finally showed up. This is the bottom of turn three. These guys showed up. They machine gunned into Marbo, but he went to ground and he made all of his 2+ saves, including against the insta-kills. So that was an amazing moment. These guys just shimmied over here and gunned down the last remaining two guys with Meltas. These tanks were both shaken, so they just went flat out. These guys flew up, gunned down a few guys there. The council managed to chop and explode 2 tanks. These guys, a couple popped out, a couple guys died, and they got pinned. So that was a tough round for Imperial Guard. But we are on to bottom of turn 3. Yeah, back in a bit. Surrounding up the bottom of turn 3, this guy kept rolling out here with his flamer, tried to flame these 2 guys but didn't succeed. These 2 guys missed a lot, but the 2 guys that hit Rendon just blew away 2 guys. We forgot to do a leadership check on these guys. Whopping leadership of 8. And they make it with a 5. Alright. A pinning check, right? Here we go. Pinning check. Leadership 8. Just barely. Christmas miracle. Okay. This guy, the tank that was over here, got blown away. Even though with flat out cover saves, still passed no cover saves, and actually Hullfield's failed. He exploded. And this guy, again, his cover save meant nothing, as last cannon here managed to glance him and stop him from shooting. So the glory of fire prisms is revealed game after game. Okay, back in a bit. On to turn 4. All right, so we just rounded up the top of turn 4. The game has ended. The Imperial Guard have surrendered. I mean, it was a bit of a rout. The council flew in here, slaughtered one squad outright with the heavy flamers, and then was ready to just start chopping things. Things were ready to keep shooting, so we called it there. But besides the Seer Council slaughtering everything, I think it was an RA game. It was a good game, man. Thanks. All right.